Hi, my name is Rebecca, and I have how do you create moons?
My name is Jim Lattice. I'm the director of UW Space Place. So what defines a moon? It's pretty much that if it orbits a planet, then it's a moon. So moons seem to form in several different ways. For example, when we look at Jupiter and the moons of Jupiter, particularly the large moons, the four large moons that we call the Galilean moons, those moons look like a small solar system with Jupiter as in the role of the sun. From the innermost one to the outermost show a variation in composition reminiscent of the variation in composition that we see in the planets. Those moons all orbit in a common plane too, and so it looks like they formed along with Jupiter. That whole system probably formed together. Another kind of moon that we see though is our own Earth's moon, which did not form along with the Earth. In the case of our moon, the best theory is that our moon results from a collision of the what would become the Earth, sort of the proto-Earth, and a proto-planet, another planet that was destroyed in the collision. And the debris from that collision, very, very early in the solar system, then turned into our moon. Another sort of moon is the moons that arise from being captured by a planet. So Mars's two very small, very asteroid-like moons are quite possibly asteroids that Mars along the way has captured from the asteroid belt. One particularly interesting moon is Titan, which is the largest of Saturn's moons. And it's actually a very complicated world that has a temperature that's about right for fluids to exist both in frozen and liquid and vapor form. And if you think about it, that's what's happening on the Earth with water. We have ice and liquid water and water vapor all interacting in basically what we consider our weather and climate system. On Titan, that's methane and other hydrocarbon liquids.